In this video, we'll be looking at Irving's algorithm, which was proposed as a solution to the stable remake problem. What is the stable remake problem? The stable remake problem is a variation on the stable marriage problem that was solved by the Gale-Shapley algorithm. Instead of having two distinct sets of people, as in the stable marriage problem, the stable remake problem has a single set of people from which they must be matched in pairs internally. One of the 12 research problems Donald Knuth proposed on the stable marriage problem was solving the stable remake problem within polynomial time. What is stability? Stability is a fairly simple concept. Imagine you have two pairs, the pair A and B, and the pair C and D. If A would prefer being with C, then being with B, and if C would prefer being with A, then being with D, the matching is not stable. A complete matching is stable if, for all pairs of elements, this is never the case. Irving's solution. In 1985, Irving wrote a paper simply titled An Efficient Algorithm to the Stable Remakes Problem. The algorithm he put forward is the one that we will be examining today, and importantly, has a worst case time of O n squared. Example 1. Let us see where this problem may arise. Imagine a tennis doubles tournament is being held at a local club, and six competitors arrive unmatched, hoping to find a partner on the day. Each of them is asked to rank the others in order of preference. With an even number of unmatched competitors, each having their own personal ranking list containing all other unmatched persons, we may begin applying Irving's algorithm. Here we can see a table, which is actually each competitor's preference list aligned as the rows of the table. Henceforth, we shall refer to each member in the table with only the first letter of their name. Here we have our first proposal. Alan proposes to Charles, and as we assume that any match is preferable to no match, anyone who has yet to be proposed to will automatically accept the first proposal made to them. Note the colours in the table. Charles is green in Alan's preference list, because he is someone that Alan has proposed to, and Alan is yellow in Charles' proposal list, because he has proposed to Charles. This next proposal, Beth proposes to Florence and is accepted, and now Charles proposes to Beth, and Beth accepts. Notice that even though Beth has already proposed to Florence, she still hasn't accepted any proposals, so she's still free to accept Charles's. Next, David proposes to Edward, and then now Edward proposes to Charles. This is the first rejection that will happen in this algorithm, because Edward proposes to Charles, and Charles has Edward higher on his preference list than Alan. Charles then rejects Alan, and Alan also rejects Charles, and accepts Edward instead. Now that Alan no longer has any accepted proposal, we return to him for a second proposal, whereupon he proposes to David, who accepts. Now Florence proposes to Edward, but is rejected as Edward prefers his current match, David, to Florence. Thus, they both reject each other. And finally, Florence proposes to Alan, who accepts, bringing phase one to a close. However, even though we now have pairs, each person actually has proposed to a different person than they accepted a proposal from. We need to trim the results and find a stable matching. In phase two, we look at every proposal in turn, and the person who was proposed to rejects all those lower in their preference list than the proposer. For example, in the Alan-David proposal, this means that David rejects all those below Alan in preference. However, no one actually fills this criteria. Now we look at the Beth-Florence proposal, and again, no one is lower than Beth in Florence's proposal list. Then we look at the Charles-Beth proposal, and this is again the case. Next, we look at the David-Edward proposal, and while David is not last in Edward's proposal list, the only person below him, Florence, has already been rejected by Edward, and therefore no more rejections need happen. Now we look at the Edward-Charles proposal, and Florence is again on the rejection list, and this time she has not yet been rejected by Charles, and so she is rejected. Finally, we reach the last rejection. In the Florence-Alan proposal, Alan prefers Florence to Edward, and therefore Edward is rejected. Now we move on to phase three. This is the most complicated phase, and we no longer care about proposals. We now instead must begin to assemble cycles. A cycle is a list of people containing the final element within the previous ones. We also assemble a list of second preferences. Let's call the cycle P and the list of second preferences Q. We then use these rules to construct the cycle. Qi is Pi's second preference, and Pi plus 1 is Qi's last preference. A Upon completing a cycle, we reject all pairs of qi pi plus 1. Now, let's take, for example, how we construct this first cycle. We start with Alan as p1. Now we look at Alan's second preference that remains on his list. Because he's rejected Charles, his list starts with David and then goes to Beth. Therefore, Beth is it becomes q1. Now we look at Beth's last preference, Charles, who now gets added as p2. Then we look at Charles's second preference, which is David, who gets added as q2. And then David's last preference gets added as p3. David's last preference is Alan, who has already appeared in the list p. Therefore, p becomes a cycle, and we reject all qi pi plus 1, which in this case are the pairs Beth and Charles, David and Alan. In the next, I will progress through these cycles in a logical order. The cycle starting with Alan until he has only one member left in his preference list, and then continuing on to the cycle starting with Beth, etc. This isn't necessary, but it's a helpful way of working through them systematically. Do note that there will, because of the strict rules of assembling cycles, there will only be one cycle for a set of preference lists that begins with one person. So now we will just continue moving through. At this stage, Alan no longer has a second preference to be had, as he only has one item in his preference list. Therefore, we move on to starting with Beth. And we continue until finally we are left with each person having only a single element in their preference list. And we have our stable pairs. Alan is paired with Florence, Beth with David, and Charles with Edward. This example went well, providing us with a stable matching at the end. However, as Gale and Shapley noticed when discussing this problem, stable matches are not always found. Let's review an example in which there are no stable matchings. Example 2. Six diplomats from six unnamed countries must form pairs to attend a meal. However, the preference lists that they have assembled will make finding stable pairs difficult. Here is their preference table, laid out the same way as last time. Thankfully, a quick glance at their table of preference can tell us each of their first preferences is unique. This means that we can tell that phase 1 will end with no rejections, as everyone will be proposing to somebody who has yet to be proposed to and will therefore be guaranteed to be accepted. Phase 2 passes similarly quickly. Every diplomat's first choice had them as their last choice. Therefore, no rejections happen in this phase either, and we move straight to the final phase. In this first cycle, we reject Xavier and Winston's pair, Violet and Yvette, Ulrich and Xavier. Next, we reject Zach and Winston, Ulrich and Yvette, Xavier and Zach and Yvette. Next, we reject Zach and Ulrich. And now we reach a point where, starting with Ulrich, it's not possible to make a cycle because Zach has no second preference with which to continue the list. Therefore, we move on to starting with Violet. And we find a cycle, and we find a cycle, and we find a cycle. Unfortunately, at this point, Zach has now been rejected by everyone. This is the condition that denotes failure of the algorithm. No stable match is possible. The diplomats will go hungry tonight. This is a pseudocode. Feel free to pause the video at this point and look over this at your leisure. Now we'll move on to discussing the time complexity of the algorithm. When Donald Knuth requested an algorithm to solve the stable roommates problem, he requested it to be done in polynomial time. This algorithm does this, and in Irving's paper he analyses the algorithm, explaining that its complexity is On squared. Initializing the various lists of preferences takes On squared steps. Phase 1 and phase 2 together take in the order of On squared steps, as there can be at most n squared rejections. For this same reasoning, phase 3 also takes On squared time. Therefore, the total complexity is On squared plus On squared plus On squared, or just On squared. Our references. Our primary reference, from which we took the algorithm and its complexity, is of course Irving's paper, An Efficient Algorithm to the Stable Roommates Problem. This can be found following this link. And we also took one example from the Wikipedia page on the Stable Roommates Problem. Thank you for watching.